In spring 2013, University of Kentucky design students were charged with imagining the future. If the Center for Applied Energy Research got the funding to install 100 acres of algae tubes to take coal flue gas and make jet fuel, what would that look like?
The imagery that they're able to produce really helps people get their imagination going about what this could look like. What could a power plant look like in 20 years? Well, hey, they've got a design. They've got a lab, a processing facility, and 100 acres of algae laid out on this site next to a CO2 source on the Ohio River. So maybe there is an application there. If a group of engineers were designing it, everything would be in straight lines, and maybe we missed something. Maybe there is some contour of the land that we missed in trying to make it easier to build. They bring value because they can imagine the future and maybe a more creative future than other people could.
It's a great opportunity to work with these students because their creativity is unlimited. They're enthusiastic, they have great ideas, they're just not confined by anything, which is refreshing. We tend to forget that this is actually a really cool thing.
Well, I think what I would do is I would make one, leave it on one side, right? And have them all be on your central access points.
Oh, okay. That's pretty much my main idea, is to leave it like as open and flexible like as I possibly could.
As you can see, the raw enthusiasm when we open up the greenhouse doors, and when they look at those same tubes, they are just overwhelmed, and the questions just begin flowing.
Two previous classes had partnered with CAER on algae designs, but this was the first class to create a design for East Bend Station, a site that's more than theoretical.
When we moved to East Bend recently, we had a partner in Duke Energy who really liked the project and was excited about it. I mean, looked actually to be planning long term, so it seemed a perfect opportunity to take the College of Design up to East Bend and kind of look at the possibilities. That's a starting scale. It actually works within the landscape up at East Bend. It also starts to approach some of the numbers that are being thrown around by the DOE that they'd like to see. But if we could get 100 acres to work, I think it's got a bright future. And at that scale, it begins to make sense to have a facility there rather than commuting.
So it really creates the perfect architecture project where there's a big landscape of hundreds of acres of algae bioreactor tubes with ancillary buildings that would house laboratories for researchers, processing facilities to process the algae into useful mediums like biofuels and jet fuel. And it also presented a fascinating challenge to provide accommodations for all of the vehicles and people that would be moving on and off the site.
My favorite part has been it kind of incorporating the practical with the inventive and meeting the engineers' needs with what they want and how they function and how they'll use the space. The engineers have kind of act as clients for us. It's gonna be very similar to how we will function as real architects. We haven't gotten that in other studios before, and so this is really the first time that we're experiencing how to apply our knowledge with the real world and involve a client.
When you're talking to engineers, they're more concerned about whether it's gonna work or not. Taking that functionality and adding an artistic value to it is what we're really trying to do here, because that's what we do. We do design.
My students are looking at it as this really amazing, surreal landscape that must be experienced. All of them are looking at ways to choreograph the movement through the algae bioreactors. What is it like to approach it, to drive through it, to get out of your car and walk up to a research lab within it, or to visit? And, you know, how does this landscape inspire people to think about energy in a new way?
So you have this thing putting out smoke, and then you have these nice green tubes, which are saving the world. Very stark contrast to put next to each other, but it works well.
I would say that for Kentucky, our unique experience comes with a local culture. I doubt any other state, except maybe West Virginia, might integrate coal power plants into a design project, which I think is a lot more real world based.
That power plant is juxtaposed with new innovative technologies that are trying to move us towards alternative energy sources. So it's been a great education from a sustainability standpoint. Students aren't just learning about windmills and solar panels as good and coal as bad, but we're learning and talking every day about how do we transition from a coal economy and coal energy to alternative fuels, slowly, steadily, and how do we participate in that transition?